Okay, but what's next?
I guess content is up next.
Content!
Yes!
Sorry, it's just so funny. Today we're going to go through 9 different ways to create a landing page that actually converts. And the best part of this tutorial is that instead of using some vague theory, we're actually going to go through some real and practical examples. So, meet Emma from our marketing team. And by the way, Emma has 3 kids. So, let's just imagine that Emma has recently launched an online language school for kids. And now, our task is to create a landing page for Emma's school. So, let's go through the steps that we need to take in order to create a convertible landing page for Emma's online school. Let's go! First off, we have to decide on the design of our landing page. Of course, here a lot depends on whether you work with some ready-made templates or you have a designer. In that case, I think we're really lucky at Liana that we have our own team of designers who can do custom design for us.
That's great.
Yeah, and of course, our design should be coherent with our brand in general and with our brand guidelines, because if we talk about a language school for kids, then I would say we should add some bright colors and also some pictures of happy kids, for example, or happy families.
Yeah, totally.
Yeah, and of course, we have to decide on the goal of a particular landing page. Let's say if the goal is to drive more sales, then our page needs to have at least several sections describing the features of our language school. And we also need to have a blog for a testimonial and a form, of course.
Yeah.
Okay, so now we have the design set.
Yes.
And now we need to decide if we want to have a short landing page or a longer one. And do you, Elena, know when you should use a long or short landing page?
No, tell me more.
Well, a good rule of thumb is that shorter landing pages usually increase the numbers of leads, while a longer landing page gives more quality leads. And like you said earlier, you should find out the purpose of the landing page and who you're targeting. Like stressed mothers like myself, for example, we don't have time or energy to scroll down lots of content, while someone who is buying like a car, for example, they want to know every single little detail about that car. And shorter landing pages, they are really trendy right now because our attention span is getting shorter and shorter. So we only have a few seconds before we keep scrolling down. And in my experience, you should use shorter landing pages when you want to offer something for free, for example, like download a guide or special offer or sign up for the newsletter. And the longer landing pages, they have obviously more room for content. So you can use that when you want your audience to dig deeper into something, when they want to have all their questions answered, for example.
Okay, so in our case, we can go with a longer one if we want to drive more sales and more qualified requests.
Yeah, obviously. Because also it seems to be like longer landing pages are good for something that is more expensive.
Yeah.
Like expensive services or products tend to be longer landing pages.
Okay.
And also longer landing pages are better for SEO in the long run. That is something that good to keep in mind.
And the SEO part, we're definitely going to talk more about that a bit later.
We are.
Yes.
Yeah, so now we have decided if we want a long or a short landing page, and then we need a headline. And obviously that's the first thing that your audience see when they arrive to your landing page. So I would say that it's crucial that you have a really good killer headline. And if you use your creativity here, you can really write a killer headline, and that will of course increase the chances that people will scroll down on your page.
Okay, but what kind of headline can we come up with for our language school, for your language school?
My awesome language school.
Yes.
Well, obviously there's tons of different ways on how you can write them, but some of my favorite tips are like the how-tos, for example. Mm-hmm. They are so easy to use and they are usually always a safe move. Everything that you can start with how to would go. So So here for my awesome language school, I would use something like how to make your child learn a new language, for example.
Sounds great.
Mm-hmm. You can also, of course, ask your audience a question. For example, do you want to know how your child can learn a new language? Practically everything that you can end with a question mark usually works really well. Or this way. You can also use lists where you list like 10 reasons why your child should learn a new language. Those are also really easy because you see what you get into before you actually commit the time to read the whole article.
Yeah, and I think numbers work really well.
Yeah, they're usually really, really appealing to your eye when you read about it.
Yeah.
And then you can use maybe testimonials. That's actually one of my favorite ones. Mm-hmm. Tips here, everyone, because then you don't actually have to do the work yourself.
True.
You can use a testimonial from one of your loyal customers, and that's great. Yeah, but just make sure that it looks natural. Like you don't want to start to polish it so it looks like it came straight out of the marketer's mouth. That's not really appealing.
Okay, but what's next?
Then we need content, and we need to plan the content well, and we need to think about in what order we want to put it. We can like put ourselves in our audience shoes and think about what we want to know about first when arriving to a page. And then obviously we need good and relevant content. And I guess we're all so tired of this 90% sale signs or long and boring lists of boring futures. And instead we can try to show the audience why would they benefit from buying our services or product. Like instead of putting an ad with the sign up for 3 months of class, then we can use something like give your child an opportunity to study abroad.
Yeah, I love that.
Yeah.
And then call to action. And yeah, call to action button is the big piece of the puzzle. Of course, the call to action button copy can vary from, I don't know, call us, book a demo, download the guide. Here a lot depends on our goal, obviously. But the key thing is to make our call to action button stand out on our landing page. So what kind of call to action button would we come up with? Because it also needs to follow the headline. They need to be coherent.
Maybe we could have something like learn a new language now, for example.
Yeah, that's a good one.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, we need to take into account the SEO part. If we talk in a less nerdy way, we have to make sure that the content of our landing page corresponds to what people are actually searching for on Google. Let's actually take a look at what kind of keywords people search for in relation to language schools. So we can use the Google Ads keyword plan tool for that. And let's see what kind of search queries are sort of outstanding. Okay, it looks like Spanish classes for kids are really popular. So for example, if we have if your language school offers Spanish classes,
of course it does.
Yeah, because it's the awesome language school.
Yeah.
So we can create a dedicated landing page for that.
Mm-hmm.
Also, what else do we have? Yeah, Mandarin and Chinese. And this one is really surprising to me. Language classes for toddlers.
Yeah,
it looks like to be a really popular keyword. Mm-hmm. So if it's relevant to our service, we can definitely use it.
Yeah, of course.
And then it's really important to build trust and credibility on our landing page. Yeah. So we have to add some customer testimonials, for example. It could be a quote from, I don't know, a happy mother or a happy kid who really improved language skills. And there was this study that I found. Look, it turns out that 92% of customers actually read online reviews before making purchase. I just didn't expect that this number will be so high, 92%.
No, but it still totally makes sense to do that before you purchase something.
True. Okay, videos. Well, I don't think there is a need to mention that video content is just booming these days.
No.
So we definitely have to take advantage of the video content on our landing page or on your landing page as well. So what kind of videos can we add? It could be an explainer video. For example, we can show what an online class looks like that kids actually easily interact with teachers online. There is no pressure. The process is actually enjoyable. It could be also a testimonial video, so we can shoot some happy family or some, I don't know, happy kids and how their life changed after they started learning languages with our school.
Yeah. You know?
Yeah. And one important thing to take into account, if we talk about video content on our landing page, videos can really slow down the page load.
Yeah.
So if we plan to target some locations with bad internet connections, maybe using videos is the wrong call.
Yeah, that's a really good point.
Yeah. And one more I would add here, because videos, they usually take quite much space on the landing page.
Yeah, true.
So we have to make sure that it does not prevent our users from filling in the form, so they can still take the desired action for us. Okay, now that everything is ready, first of all, let's celebrate the launch. But what happens next? Now is the time to actually measure the effectiveness of our landing page and measure the performance of our landing page. We can start with, for example, setting some heat maps to see how users interact with the page, what sections are mostly visited and what sections are completely skipped, for example. Hotjar is a nice tool for setting heat maps.
Yeah.
And then we can check some of the most important stats on Google Analytics, for example, the average time spent on page, the bounce rate, and of course, conversions. And the last tip for here, if you really want to have an overview of all your marketing channels and if you want to see how your landing page performs against, for example, other marketing channels that you use, then I would recommend Google Data Studio. And just like that, we have planned our future landing page for Emma School. And if you want to learn more about landing pages and if you simply want to get inspired, I would highly recommend you checking out the article on our blog, and we're going to put the link to the article below the video, right?
Yeah, and we will also link a few of our own landing pages, short and long ones, so you can see the difference and get inspired by them.
And compare.
Yes.
Thank you. Hi, sister.